This is an introduction to the distributive property of multiplication over addition. So this is part one. Remember the different ways to write multiplication in algebra. So before we do the property, we have to go over a couple things. Keep in mind a number or variable next to a parentheses symbol means to multiply. And a variable next to another variable or number also means to multiply. So the following are equal since they all mean m times n. You could have a dot between the m and the n. You could have one of the variables in parentheses, both variables in parentheses, or you could put the variables right next to each other. Now, just keep in mind that it's different for numbers. So if instead of an n, you had something like 7 times 3, you could have it written almost all of these ways. You could not just put the 7 next to the 3. So for numbers, you can't just write 7, 3, right? To mean multiply 73. All right, so as long as one of them is a variable, you can write it this last way, just putting them next to each other. But otherwise, if one of them is a variable, there's all these different ways we could write it. All right, so here's the distributive property of multiplication over addition. So what we've got is A parentheses B plus C equals AB plus AC. And then I'm just writing down, keep in mind what this means. It means A times B plus C is the same thing as A times B plus A times C. Well, let's see if this works for a particular example, see if it's really true. So let's say you were doing 3 parentheses 4 plus 5. Well, if I was using my order of operations, I would simplify inside the parentheses, which is 3 times 9, and that would give me an answer of 27. And then the question is, what if I had written this as 3 times 4 plus 3 times 5? Using my order of operations, writing it this way, I would have 12 plus 15, which is also 27. So you can see that these two do end up actually being equal since they both simplify to be 27. So this is just an example only to show you that it actually works for some particular numbers. Often people use the distributive property without thinking about it. So here's how you might use this property at the store without thinking about it. Let's say you want to buy 13 pencils at 7 cents each. So most people know that would be 13 times 7 or 7 times 13. But you might just think, well, 10 pencils at 7 cents each cost 70 cents and 3 more at 7 cents each cost 21 cents, so that's a 91 cents total. That's just the distributive property. So how is that? So you have 7 times 13. What you're doing is breaking up that 13 into 10 plus 3. And then you do 7 times 10 and 7 times 3 to get 70 plus 21, or 91. So even though you're not getting out a piece of paper and doing all this algebra, in your head, basically you ended up doing 7 times 10 probably, and 7 times 3, and then adding them together. So that would be, you know, one use of where it's done. Here are a couple of examples. Now, one question might be, why do we even have the distributive property? Well, if you're trying to simplify something, we're going to do the order of operations, which means you simplify inside parentheses first. Well, x plus 8, you can't simplify any further. You can't combine those because we don't know what x is. So then the next thing in order of operations would be multiplication. And that's exactly what this is, 5 times something. And the only way to do multiplication in this case is to use the distributive property of multiplication over addition. So the distributive property of a way of simplifying things to remove parentheses. So we have 5 times x times 5 times 8. So we could write 5 times x plus 5 times 8, which is written, you don't ever leave your answer like that with these dots, 5x, because 5 times x means 5x, and 5 times 8, oops, that's not, would be plus 40. All right, try this other one on the right. Okay, so we have 4 times m doing the same thing. We're going to distribute what's in front of the parentheses to both things inside, timesing it by each thing separated by the plus sign. So we've got 4 times m. Can you do that? Just write 4m plus 4 times 13. Now, you do not have to write this middle step 4 times 13. You can do that in your head. I remember 4 times 13 by thinking of a deck of cards. I've got 4 suits, 13 in each. I know there's 52 cards in a deck. So that's how I remember that, even though it's not in my regular multiplication tables. Okay, how about trying another one? How about 6 times 2m plus 7? All right, so we're going to distribute the 6 by multiplying it into each thing in the parentheses. Again, you can't simplify inside the parentheses. Order of operations still prevails. If you can simplify inside, then you go ahead and do that. So we have 6 times 2m plus 6 times 7. All right, now how do we deal with this? This means 6 times 2 times m. You can multiply the 6 and 2 together. So that's a 12m plus 6 times 7 is 42. So what you're doing when you're using the distributive property is you're simplifying something by getting rid of the parentheses. Since you can't combine inside the parentheses and multiply it, you have to use the distributive property. All right, let's go on to another one. How about 8 times 3m plus 4? Okay, try this on your own. So we get 8 times 3m plus 8 times 4, and again, you could multiply the 3 and the m together. The 8 and the 3 together. 24m plus 32. In another video, we're going to go over how to deal with some problems that have subtraction in them, or minus signs, negative numbers. But let's just simplify a little bit further. How about if we had something like 3 times x plus 8 plus 14. So using the order of operations again, first you look inside the parentheses and you can't combine these in any way. So then you do multiplication right here, which is the distributive property. So that we have 3x plus 3 times 8. Can we do that on our head? 3 times 8 would be 24. Plus 14. And now you have to look and see if there's anything you can combine further. And I have a 24 plus a 14 that you can add together. So the 3x can't be combined. Since we don't know what x is, we can't combine that. So we have 3x plus 38. So here's one for you to try. All right, so you're doing 5 times 2x plus 5 plus 9. All right, so let's do the distributive property first. 5 times 2x and 5 times 5 will give us 10x. Can you do that in your head? 5 times 2x and 5 times 5 is 25 plus 9. And again, we can combine the 25 and the 9 together, 10x. Plus 34. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.